Good evening and welcome. Let's take a look at our top story this hour. Armenia's Prime Minister Nikol Pashinyan has said that he was sure that Russia would come to the country's defense if necessary amid conflict with Azerbaijan over the disputed region of Nagorno-Karabakh. The statement came as heavy fighting continued in Nagorno-Karabakh, which is internationally recognized as a part of Azerbaijan but is ruled by ethnic Armenians.
Ստիրավիճակի իր պայմանագրային պարտավորությունները կկատարի։ Ինչ վերաբերում է Լեռնային Ղարաբաղի հակամարտության կարգավորմանը, գիտեք, որ գոյությունն է ԵԱՀԿ Մինսկի խմբի համանախագահությունը, որի անդամ են Ռուսաստանը, Միացյալ Նահանգները և Ֆրանսիան, և բնականաբար նաև հակամարտության կողմերը այս պրոցեսի մաս են։
Dozens of Armenians, army reservists, and volunteers between the ages of 20 and 50 have boarded buses that are headed towards the border with Nagorno-Karabakh. Meanwhile, Russia has called for an immediate end to the fighting between the two former Soviet countries of Armenia and Azerbaijan. Meanwhile, Turkish state media accessed footage reportedly showing the moment a missile hit the Azeri city of Ganja, calling Armenia an occupier. Ankara has said that the world must support Azerbaijan.
Ermenistan'la Azerbaycan'ı eşit mesafede tutmak ya da eşit mesafede yaklaşmak bu iki ülkeye işgalciyi ödüllendirmek anlamına gelir. Dünya haklının yani Azerbaycan'ın yanında yer almalıdır.
For more on the conflict, we are being joined by Sonia Agbalyan, World News Editor of Armenian Public TV. Good evening and thank you for being with us. Now, heavy fighting continues between the two sides, and now dozens of Armenians, army reservists and volunteers are headed towards the border with Nagorno-Karabakh. What is the latest?
Hello, thank you for the opportunity. Yes, the heavy fighting is going on, and Azerbaijan is still striking on Stepanakert and Shushi. On the civilian settlements, and this is the main problem, and yeah, many civilians died from late in the evening yesterday till now, and the heavy shelling continues, and what is the worst, the Azerbaijani side with the back of Turkish military strikes with not only with drones but also with cluster bombs, cluster munitions, which are banned internationally, as you know, and this is the main reason of this many losses and casualties and these victims.
Asana, Armenia's Prime Minister has said that he was sure of Russia's backing if the country needed it, if necessary. Now, Russia is calling for an immediate end to the fighting.
Yeah, definitely. We will have the back of Russia because we have the agreement, but we haven't asked Russia for the help yet, because the only help we need from the international community and Russia as well and Moscow as well is the fight against terrorists. Because now Armenia alone, Armenian armed forces alone are striking and fighting not only against Azerbaijani soldiers and Turkish soldiers, but also with terrorist groups from Syria and Libya. And this fact has already many evidences, and this is what we ask for Russia and the world, to help not with the fight with Azerbaijani army and Turkish army, but with the fight against terrorists.
Right, now Turkey is calling Armenia an occupier. Ankara has said that the world must support Azerbaijan.
Definitely, it's a war, and they are going to accuse Armenia because they cannot accept that they were the first to attack. But you can see many evidences from Mr. Erdogan's speech that he is going to attack not only Armenia to take back, not only Armenia, but also Jerusalem, Eastern Mediterranean, as Mr. Erdogan thinks that the whole world belongs to him, because he is going to rebuild, and maybe he has the dream of rebuilding the Ottoman Empire. But definitely there are evidences, and Armenia has always insisted on bringing monitoring mechanisms to the border see who was the first to attack, let alone the Azerbaijani president lately announced by mistake that they were the first to attack Nagorno-Karabakh. So I call on the international community and the observers in the European Union to put monitoring mechanisms, which we insist on, in spite of Azerbaijan, to see who was the attacker and who was the first to attack.
Sona, thank you very much for being with us and bringing us all of the latest there from Armenia in this conflict.